Did you know you can boil water with just your hands? Actually, you also need a syringe. Find out how in the science snack, Boyle-ing Water. We're used to water boiling at 100 degrees C, but it turns out that the boiling point of water is actually dependent on both its temperature and its pressure. At lower pressures, water boils at a lower temperature. You know this if you've ever tried to cook at higher elevations. There, the pressure's lower and water will boil at a lower temperature and maybe not get to the temperature that you need in order to cook your food. So all we need to do to boil water at a lower temperature is to create a low pressure environment. All you need for this snack is a plastic disposable syringe and water. I normally like to use a 10 milliliter syringe for this, but so it's easier for you to see, I have this jumbo 60 mil syringe. Whether it's a 10 mil syringe or a 60 mil syringe, just fill it about a third full with water. And then you'll notice you probably got some air in there. And what you want to do is remove as much air as possible. So you can do the things that maybe you've seen on TV where you squeeze all the air out. And if a little bit of water comes out, that's just fine. The important thing here is to remove all of the air. Now we have a syringe, a third full of water. Take your finger and plug the end of the syringe. And you want to pull back the plunger. And you'll notice that a giant air bubble forms, a bunch of air comes into your syringe, even though you just got rid of all of it. That's actually the dissolved air that was in your water. If you slowly release the plunger, some of that dissolved air will stay out of solution, and then you can squeeze it out of the syringe even more. And so now we have a syringe full of water with less dissolved air in it. I'm going to pull back the plunger one more time, and this time I'm just going to let it go quickly. And that is going to create really teeny tiny bubbles in here. And those little baby bubbles are going to help seed the bubbles that will start to form when we boil the water. And the water is going to boil this third time we pull back on the plunger. And if I pull back slowly, you can all of a sudden see all of these bubbles forming. And that means we've reduced the pressure in the syringe enough for the water to boil. It turns out that for water to boil at room temperature, the pressure needs to be decreased about 30 times. That means if we can increase the volume of the air in here 30 times, we'll have the pressure at least low enough for the water to boil. If you think about these tiny little microliter-sized bubbles, once I pull this back, they turn into milliliters of air. And so that's more than enough for the pressure to go down. And all of a sudden, you're holding a syringe full of boiling water. And you're not burning yourself. This relationship between the pressure and the volume of a gas is known as Boyle's law. That's why this snack is known as boiling water.